I'm here to talk a bit about Mofibo. Just short to introduce myself, Morten Strunge. I'm 29 years old. I founded my first company when I was 13. That didn't go very well, so I've also tried losing a lot of money, but I was also successful once at least, with founding a telecom company called Unphone back in 2006, which was sold to the largest operator in Denmark, TDC, in 2011. I then stayed on with TDC for a couple of years, and whilst I was there, I attended a course or a lecture where there was a lot of other people from the media industry, and there also there was a lot of CEOs from the publishing industry. And they talked to me about digitalization and how they saw digitalization and how they saw books. And then I got the idea for Mofibo. Mofibo is a subscription service, very much like Netflix, Spotify. You pay a fixed fee of equivalent to €9.99 per month, and then you have unlimited access to both ebooks and audiobooks. But while speaking to these publishing CEOs and so on, I also found out that I saw books and reading quite differently to what they did. They saw books as this, they had a, like a lot of people, or some people have a belief around books that it's so special, it's so unique. For me, I don't read a lot. I think before I started Mofibo, I maybe read 10 books in my life. So it's not from love to literature. But I also asked myself, why is it I don't read anymore, any more than I do? Because I spent a lot of time on entertainment, and in general, people, they haven't spent as much time as they do now on entertainment. They spent a lot of time on Facebook, Spotify, Netflix, and so on. And when you ask people out there, if I ask you, you can say, a lot of people, they say, I don't read enough. But I would like to read more, but unfortunately I don't have the time. But that's bullshit. You do have the time. You just prioritize differently. So the idea and concept with Mofibo is actually to see how we could make the book, take it from a project for a lot of people. Reading is a project. It's this book which lies at the bed, next to the bed, which you maybe open every month or every second month or whatever, to really taking the book and integrating it in the everyday life, making it more accessible. So it doesn't become a project, but it becomes a natural part of your way of entertainment, like it is to go on Facebook for 5 minutes, to listen to Spotify for 10 minutes or whatever. Why couldn't you read or listen to an audiobook on the way to work for 5 or 10 minutes? So I don't see us in the book industry. I see us, we're in the entertainment industry. Our competitors, they're these guys. I don't see the physical book retailers as our competitors. I see the real competition is how we get the customer to click on the Mofibo icon instead of clicking on Facebook, Spotify, or whatever other services. And as I see it, the key for this is relevance and accessibility. And those are the two things I'm going to talk a bit about. But before that, I would like to talk a little bit about the model we have at Mofibo. It's a crazy model. We give a fixed service to the consumer, so they pay a fixed fee, but we actually have a variable cost. So if a customer reads 10 books, we lose money, shitloads of money actually. If he reads one or two books, then we actually earn money. So when we launched the company back in summer of 2013, we got in around €10 per customer, and we lost around €25 per customer net. So it was a very, very bad business, because what we saw is that we gave customers access to around 20,000 books, but they didn't really choose the right books for them, at least. They had access to thousands of titles, but they kept on choosing books which they didn't finish. And then they maybe read 20% of the book, and then they chose another book and read 30% of that, and then another one which they might finish. So we quickly found out that we needed to understand the segments much better, and we needed to understand our books much better in order to match up the books with our customers. So if I start with recommendation, as we pay per book, if we're successful in recommending the right book to the individual customer, They not only finished the book, which is of course good for our financials, we earn more money on that, but they are also more satisfied and they stay for longer at our subscription. As we are a subscription service, churn is number one killer of a business like ours. And the way we work with the recommendation at Mofibo is we look at the books, at each book, and we look at the time spent on a book. So the total time spent on a book, and then we divide it by the cost of the given title, and that gives us a price per minute, so to say. But then we look at this, then we take this KPI, and we compare it to all the different segments out there of our customers, 50 plus different segments. And then one book might be relevant for this person, but it might be irrelevant for this person. So if I recommend it to this guy, then he'll only read 20%, but if I recommend it to this guy, then he'll read 100%. And today, 70% of the consumption on the platform is books we control. So that's where we recommend a title. So not 30%, but 70% of all books consumed on the platform is where we actually have a stake in it, so to say. We now have a finish degree of titles. When we started off, we had it at around 40%. So only 40% finished the book. What you should remember with books is that it's not like music. It's not only 3 minutes. It's not like a series of HBO, which is 35 minutes or whatever. A book takes around 10 hours to read. So it's crucial that you recommend the right book, and it's crucial that you keep the customer into the book and so that he continues reading it. So more than 80% now finish that book. And where we are now, we have a gross margin of around 50%. That's quite good, being in a content industry. If you look on the right, on the left side, is our indexed cost, so to say, and on the right side is the user engagement. So we've managed to reduce the cost significantly per user, but we also still kept the engagement of the customer. So one thing is you can't just recommend the cheapest titles available, because then the customers will leave the service. You need to recommend intelligently. So we might have two books, one which costs 3 euros and one which costs 6 euros. And it could be much better for us to recommend the one which actually costs 6 euros if the customer then finishes it. Another way we use data is in product development. So one of the things, this part was about recommendation. Another thing is about how we can integrate the book again into everyday life. And one of the features we've had great success with is actually a feature called Flow. So it's where you, if for example, a good example is you sit in your favorite chair drinking your coffee, reading a book, and you might continue to read to page 121. And then you get on your bike the next day, you pick up your mobile phone and put on your headphones and press play, and then you continue in an audiobook from where you left the ebook. So a great way to integrate the book and make it easier to consume, so there's more times during the day where you can actually continue reading, whether you're bicycling, whether you're cooking, or whatever you're doing. So this one, this feature increases reading, but it increases significantly the customer lifetime, and it also addresses different segments. So we can see after we launched this feature, we actually target younger users and around 80% more men, because suddenly it's easier. I can do it on the way to work, I can do it while I'm cooking, I can do it while I'm taking a run or whatever. Another very cool feature, which is actually 100% SaaS system based, we call it Sneak Peek. Because our customers, they read within the app, or within our app, on either their mobile or on their tablet. We can see exactly how fast they read through a book. And in the exciting parts of the book, you tend to read faster, where if it's not that exciting, then you tend to slow down. And the bad thing about that, for us at least, is that if it isn't that much exciting for too long, then the worst thing that could happen is the customer then closes the book, so to say, and chooses another book, or leaves the service because he's bored about reading. So what we develop is one click, and then by looking at all the titles consumed on the platform, we can see exactly where the climax is in the book. So if you're bored, you just click once, and then you can see, okay, within the next 20 minutes or so, some exciting stuff is going to come up, happen, and then you continue reading. Some book people say you shouldn't do that. That's not very, but for us, it's a great way to give a much better customer experience, and people, they love it, and they finish books to a much greater degree. One thing we're also, a feature we're coming up with quite soon is a feature very much like this, but in terms of climax. So we're going to incorporate it into the recommendation engine as well. So we not just look at people who read these books, look similar to these segments and all that, but we're also going to analyze each book and say, okay, this guy, he likes crime scenes within the first 30 minutes of a book. So if I recommend him a title where there isn't a peak of crime within the first 30 minutes, but it's not until 1 hour, which might be okay for some people, then he isn't satisfied about the book, and then he won't continue reading. So we can actually put it into the engine, so we don't just look at segments and on the given book, but we also look on which climax in the type of climax you like in the book, which I think is going to be very exciting. Yeah, that's a very short speech about Mofibo. We're actually launching in the Dutch market very soon. We are in Denmark now. We launched in Sweden for a year ago. And we're launching in the Dutch market, hopefully within the next 2 months. We have all the campaigns ready. We have a lot of publishers on board already. And hopefully we'll be signing a few more contracts next week in Frankfurt. So. Please sign up within the next couple of months when we're launching in the Dutch market. So I think my time is up. Thank you.